Hey guys, Gallic here, and today I am doing a guide video for the water main. So, this is all my personal opinion, disclaimer. This is all my personal opinion on how to use the water main, what works best with the water main. So this is not guaranteed gonna get you top of your server, killing everyone. This is gonna try and guide you in an appropriate area for improving yourself, because I'm actually going to do a video on this later, but your power is going to be a huge factor in how much damage you're going to be dealing and how you're going to live and everything like that. So, without further ado, I introduce you to the water main. So, first, before we get into all the technical mumbo jumbo. I'm gonna show you guys all of her transformations because I've had a couple of people ask me that were really low level how to unlock this stuff. I believe it's been a really long time since I unlocked Battle Armor. I believe it's at level somewhere between 40 and 50. You start unlocking Battle Armor, and here are all of her transformations. So you have the rank 1 transformation. Really kind of basic. Then you've got rank 2, adds a little bit of blue. Rank 3 adds a lot of blue, obviously, water main. Rank 4, which is what I'm at right now. Rank 5, rank 6, rank 7, which I'm actually a fan of. I like rank 7, rank 8, and rank 9. So those are her battle armor transformations. And then you go up here to this tab that says clothing. And you see you get permanent power from clothing. So if you see clothing and it's at a discounted price, try and get some. It's not mandatory, but it's permanent power. And permanent power is always important. So here we go. So we have Wild West, which is kind of cool. It's enjoyable. It gives you, let's look. Wild West gives you 285 life and 200 defense. So if you're dying a lot, aim for the Wild West. Aim for the Wild West. So here's the Anbu. This is a more damage-based buff for it. I really like this skin because some of the skins, you see this little bag on her side. It goes to the other side. Even something like, where'd it go? Like this. You see how there's this little line here, or how this is on the right side of the screen. It's on her left side of her body. It goes to the right side, and that really bothers me. And as far as I can tell, the Anbu clothes are the only clothes that actually stay the same all the way around, and that makes me happy. So Anbu is more damage based. It gives you 300 attack, 300 ninjutsu, which is actually a lot. Like, that is, I think that's equivalent to a Magitama. That is more than a level 5 Magitama. That is almost two level 5 Magitamas. So that is a lot. A lot of damage. Actually, that's three attack, level 5 attack Magitamas and two level 6 ninjutsu Magitamas. So that is a lot. That is a lot of damage increase. So there's that, and then you have the summer break, which gives you 300 life, 100 initiative. Initiative is really important. Get initiative. Initiative is important. Get initiative. Eternal Belief, which gives you straight initiative. You actually get this completely for free eventually from getting power and going. Oops. You eventually will get the Eternal Belief clothing for free. Where'd it go? Here it is. The Eternal Belief clothing for free. If you have, I think, 80,000 power, which you'll get to eventually. Like that, it you will get it eventually. I don't think this is in any events, so this is the only place you can get it is when you power up. Ceremonial Kimono. A lot of people use this one. A lot of people like it with Water Main. It looks really nice. I still prefer the Anbu. Because you see the bow on her waist, it changes sides, and that really bothers me. So 165 attack, 200 defense. Really good for kind of an all-round increase. So if you see it and you need a little bit more attack and a little bit more defense, get it. It's worth it. Summer Youth Sai gives you 165 ninjutsu and 200 resistance, so exact mirrors of each other for ninjutsu and resistance and attack and defense. So a lot of people use this too because it matches with Sailor Sakura. But those are all of the clothes for the Water Maid. So getting into the nitty gritty, let's look at her stats. Details. So her life growth is ridiculously high. Way higher than, in my opinion, it should be. So here we have all of this life growth. It's ridiculously high. It's way above average. Her attack growth is way below average, and her defense growth is below average. Her ninjutsu is probably not as high as most people would want it to be, but it's the third best stat for Water Main, but it's also her best and most reliable stat. So her resistance growth is also really, really high. Like, really, really high. It's above average, but not quite as high as life growth. So keep that in mind when using her moods. Because her moods... Let's go into mood. So you're at your Water Main, you're on your mood. Life and ninjutsu are the Water Main's best stats. So keep in mind, this is 41% of this stat right here, this 1031. This 1031, 41% of that. So I'm getting 41%. So imagine if I was getting life growth. If I had 41% life, I would be getting 41% of 2199. That is a lot. That is going to increase your battle power a lot. Is it always going to help you? No. I would rather have the ninjutsu because it's more damage, more healing, more everything. So those are the stat growths. So we're going into what kind of team we want to make. This is my main team right now. If I had Han, I would be using Han, but I don't have Han. So this is kind of what we're doing. That's kind of how the Water Main plays at endgame. She becomes the best healer in the game, period. Like, hands down. Healing tips makes her an amazing healer. Period. No ifs, ands, or buts. Amazing healer. She also becomes really, really strong when... I don't think you unlock... You might unlock Neurotoxin immediately, but you may not. You definitely don't unlock Poison Tie immediately. So, Poison Tie is one of the best talents in the game, in my opinion. And we're going to be losing it eventually. So, use it while you can. This is my basic build. So, this is a recover 25% of life for the units in your field based on this unit's ninjutsu-based attribute. That is why ninjutsu is so important, in my opinion. Because that ninjutsu, the more ninjutsu she has, the more healing she does. Again, here, heals one unit with the least life from your team and disperses all debuffs on the target. See that little symbol that says nin right under the icon? That means ninjutsu. So the higher her ninjutsu is, the more healing she's going to do with this ability. Chakra Dissection Blade, this is actually a taijutsu ability. So it's not going to be buffed by ninjutsu, and it's actually not going to do a whole lot of damage because her attack growth is so low. But it is important for the next talent. So, Chakra Dissection Blade chases and attacks a knockdown unit, causes high float and critical hit. That critical hit is really important. Doesn't matter what your crit is on your character, you're always going to crit with Chakra Dissection Blade. Neurotoxin. When this unit causes a critical hit, the unit who received the critical hit will suffer from chaos, lasts for one round. That chaos is why people run Chakra Dissection Blade. It is a guaranteed chaos on whoever that Chakra Dissection Blade hits. That's what's important. Poison Tie. And just from your lineup, which attack using Taiju 2 damage will cause the same will cause at the same time poisoning. So every time any of your ninja use any ability that causes Taiju 2 damage and they cause Taiju 2 damage, they're going to poison the person that they cause damage to. That includes, but is not limited to, Sage Naruto's true Wind Style Rasen Shuriken. It includes that damage because that is Taijutsu damage, as well as Ninjutsu and Wind Attribute damage. Roshi, his Burning Ocean. Let's see if it'll pop up. Will it pop up? Yes, it will. Taijutsu, Ninjutsu, Fire Damage, and Earth Damage. So, you're going to cause poisoning, and you're going to just mess up someone's team. Then, Sailor Sakura. Katsuya attack is Taijutsu and Ninjutsu. Attacks up to 4 opponent units. This skill is not subject to the opponent's defense skill. So, that is going to... All of these abilities, even Roshi's main attack, Sage Naruto's main attack, all of it does Taijutsu damage as well as Ninjutsu. Except for Sailor Sakura. Well, actually, yeah, Sailor Sakura's does Taijutsu and Ninjutsu damage. So, number one, this is going to be really great if you're struggling on Puppet... on Puppet Ninja exams, because I struggled on them for a while. Anyway, you deal with those Taijutsu damage and Ninjutsu damage, you're golden on those. You're also going to cause poisoning with every single attack that this team does is going to cause poisoning. And poisoning stacks. That is really, really, really important. Okay, so creating a team. So for starters, the very basic team that I can think of, because you get Haku very early on. You get Haku really early in the game, so it's use her if you can because of her barrier. Her barrier buffs all water attribute ninja, so it'll buff water main because you're going to be using water main for damage mostly in the lower levels. If you get Kabuto, use Kabuto. Now, as a tank for lower levels, I would use Kimimaru. Kimimaru is an amazing, 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 amazing tank. He's going to deal a lot of damage, and he's going to take a lot of damage. Plus, because of his high possibility to evade the first standard attack every round, he's not going to be taking damage. Two, significantly increase your own defense and resistance when damaged. That is only for his 3-star and above ability, but you can get 3-star really, really quickly. Like, I'm only level 80 and I've got him at 4-star. I've had him at 4-star since I think level 60 or 65. So it's not hard to get him. You just have to put the time and effort into farming his fragments from the elite instances, and you'll get him in no time. You'll eventually get some frags from him in assorted places, that he'll show up on the black market dealer. So get him when you can. If you don't want to run those, let's say you just started the game, pretty much your best bet is going to be running a team somewhere along the lines of, where is he? He is right here. Nope, no, not that one. Not that one. You're not going to have that one. Where's the other? There he is. Okay, so Naruto is really good. Naruto is really important. You can run him. You can run both Hinata and Naruto in either slot. However, I would recommend running Naruto in the attack slot. But you're not going to have tactics yet. But kind of get used to setting up your team like this, or look up the tactics for what you want to use. I'll probably do a video on them eventually. May do that next. But most people use the ghost kill, so ninjutsu in the back, attack in the middle, life in the front. So that's how they set up their lineups. That's how I set up my lineups. I actually use Sun Move, which we'll get into that eventually. But use Naruto in front of Sasuke. He's going to be second action. So you have first action, second action, third, fourth. So your Hinata is going to be taking most of the damage. You can also move them down to something like this, so that Hinata is taking more damage than Naruto. But in my opinion, you kind of want Naruto's clones to be taking more of the damage than Hinata, because that'll make Hinata a little bit more tanky and not die as quickly, so that's always important. The main reason I recommend Hinata is she has a chase that acupunctures, and acupuncture is really important in lower levels because most teams are going to heavily, heavily, heavily rely on mystery skills going through the first, I think, 30 to 50 levels, give or take. So acupuncture is really going to help your team. So for the talents, I don't think you get this. You're not going to have any of this, at least for a little while. So use Poison Fog Wave. You're not going to have this yet, I think, until, I don't remember. I just don't even know. You're definitely not going to have this until level 50. So don't even think, pay attention to this until level 50, and then I'll do a whole video on that another time. So you're going to have Water Style, Wind Drag, Water Dragon Jutsu, Shark Bomb Jutsu, and Chakra Dissection Blade. Then you're going to have these six talents when you start out. I think when you hit level 10 or 12 or something, you unlock it. So like within an hour, you're going to unlock these. With this team, I would use Neurotoxin and Chakra Dissection Blade. And then, so you're going to have causes low float to repulse causes acupuncture and knockdown causes chaos, and so that will be a pretty good. Oh, and knockdown to high float. So this is actually a really, really solid team. This was a complete accident, actually. This is actually really solid with the chases. So you're gonna cause high float with Chakra Dissection Blade, and then Sasuke is going to go into his high float chase, which is Chidori Sharp Spear. You won't have this until Sasuke gets to 3 stars. So I would highly recommend getting Sasuke and Naruto to 3 stars if you want to use this team for a while. Get Naruto and Sasuke to 3 stars as soon as possible. As soon as possible. Because this team will last for a good 50 to 60 levels. Like, it is a really, really solid team. So if you wanted to build this team, find a way to skill break Naruto, find a way to skill break Sasuke. This team will last you at least until level 50 or 60. And just spend on power, and then once you hit level 60, you start unlocking more treasure. However, if you're using the water main, my best recommendation for you is to wait for level 70 to start pulling a lot of ninja, because that's where water main is really going to boost in power. So this team will last you a long time. Enjoy it. It's really nice. So once you start unlocking more talents, you're going to be able to use something. I would recommend using Super Shark Bomb Jutsu as soon as possible. The main reason for that is it causes ninjutsu damage to 4 of the opponent's units. Moreover, the selected unit will suffer from knockdown. This skill has a high probability of critical hit. So that critical hit, if you're running Neurotoxin, will cause chaos. So it's possible to completely chaos the enemy team by accident. That is really important. Taijutsu attack is really iffy. I mean, because it causes critical, I would run it as long as possible. If you're running into problems with taking too much damage, run healing jutsu. But Poison Fog Wave is a very good alternative, until you unlock Poison Tai. Because this will keep damage going every single round. So, running Poison Fog Wave, then you unlock Super Shark Bomb, then you unlock Poison Tai. Use Poison Tai when you can, it's really important. Pretty much, don't pay attention to Curse Mark Test unless you're using your water main strictly for damage. Then you might want to use Curse Mark Test because Sasuke is a Curse Mark Ninja. So you will be able to get that little buff for the water main. Okay, so now that you have unlocked a little bit more ninja, we're at level 60. I believe you unlock the Edo Tensei treasure and the Tendo treasure. So, Tendo treasure, Sage Mode Jiraiya is in here, Asuma Windblade, Kakashi Beheading Sword. You get Hashirama fragments, but don't rely on those unless you really, really want him. Then you can spend a whole lot of money and pray that you get enough fragments. I have pulled out of this treasure, I think, a total of 3 times. If you get any of the paints, use them. Use them, use them, use them, use them, use them. They are really good. They buff each other. They buff themselves. Like, they are 110% worth it. Hashirama is really strong because he's able to immobile up to 2 people per turn when he has his barrier out. So, being able to immobile 2 enemy characters is really, really important. And it's really, really powerful. Tendo is at 1,000 pulls in the Tendo treasure. I think. Something like that. He's at a ridiculous amount of pulls. He's really, really powerful. Like, ridiculously powerful. Like, will one-shot an enemy team powerful up to, like, level 70 or 80. So, if you get him, use him. If you get any of the paints, use them. If you're running water main and you're running into trouble with healing and taking too much damage, look for Gakido and Jikakudo, because they can. Gakido can give you a shield and basically remove all debuffs. And then Jikakudo heals and can resurrect a teammate. So that's important. So, Edo Tensei Treasure, you're going to get Kinkaku, Genkaku, Kabuto, Snake Cloak, Raza, Gengetsu, and Itachi Susanoo fragments. The only ninjas that I recommend out of here is going to be Gengetsu. Yeah, Gengetsu, that's it. Because he's actually really powerful. He comes out as 2 stars, but he hits like a truck at 2 stars. So if you're able to get him up to 3 and 4 stars eventually, he's going to be a massive boost to your team. I don't recommend Snake Cloak Kabuto. Some people like him. I don't. He generates 2 clones each turn, or 1 clone. Let me look. But he's good. He can resurrect a ninja. So, that's always something important. So he revives a selected unit from a friendly team. This unit will be revived with 10% of its original life points will be categorized as Edo Tensei unit every time. Summoning Jutsu Manda is triggered. This Mystery Seal's cooldown level is, yeah, whatever. It's reduced by 1 round. So, Dead Soul Jutsu summons 1 to 2 Dead Souls to the field. The summoned souls can be those of Konoha Ninja and Edo Tensei type ninjas. So, they'll be Edo Tensei Konoha Ninja. These summons standard attack will cause high float. Striking Shake Snake. Striking Shadow Snake. Chases and attacks a low floated, causes high float and paralysis. Ambition, each time a unit is defeated, this unit will recover 10 chakra and 10% of its life. This can be triggered 6 times a round, so that's really important. If you're running into healing issues, you can use Kabuto kind of as a pseudo tank. Summoning Jutsu Manda. It's a 30 combo, attacks 4 of the opponent's units and will cause the units to suffer from poisoning. So it's not a Kabuto Snake Cloak is not bad. I just don't recommend him because he's so situational. So don't rely on him. Rely on other ninja. So once you hit level 70, you're gonna have all these treasures unlocked. With the seal treasure, this is the first treasure you get. You get it immediately. Kisame is really good. Tsunade is decent. And Conan is good. Conan is really good. But the others, I wouldn't look for them. I wouldn't try and search for them unless you just want to complete a collection. Sage Naruto treasure. If you get Ao, use Ao. If you get Sage Naruto, use Sage Naruto. If you get Saucery, he's really situational and he's better for other teams. So he's not someone I would pull for. But Sage Naruto is worth it 110%. So, five Kage treasure. Your best ninja out of here are going to be Darui, Mei, and Chojuro. Specifically, Mei and Chojuro. The basic water main. Oh, and Mabui. Mabui is really, really good. So basically, there's a water cancer team. I put it. I fought against it during the Matsuri video that I posted earlier. So basically, what it is it is. There are two different variations of it. So you have. It's kind of like this, give or take. So you have Mabui here. Then you have Chojuro or Great Ninja War 1010, and then you have Mei, and then you have your water main. It is really, really, really strong. It is really, really, really powerful, and it can really mess up someone's team. Chojuro by himself can really mess up someone's team, but Chojuro gets a buff from all water ninja. Chojuro, not Chojuro. Chojuro. So he causes water attribute damage to the opponent's entire team and high float to the selected opponent's unit. That's his mystery. Then sweep attack. Attack three units at the front at random and has a chance of repulse. Ninja Sword, two standard attacks will be launched each round. So he hits up to three units each round. Twice. So that's six times he's damaging someone. That's ridiculous. Water style, water wall. Water wall chases and attacks a high floated unit, causes repulse. Power of water increase ninjutsu and attack attribute of Chojuro by 6% for each water attribute ninja in your lineup. You can have up to four, so that's 24% damage increase. 24% is ridiculously huge. Now, one of the reasons that I don't like that Mei Chojuro Mabui lineup is because my opinion is that the Ao Chojuro and Mei and Water Main. So you have Ao here, Chojuro here, Mei here where the Sasuke is, and then you have your Water Main. So you have Chojuro, I don't have Chojuro or Mei, otherwise I would show you exactly what it looks like. So you have Chojuro here, he goes first. Then you have Ao, and then you have Mei, and then you have your water main. So Ao creates two water clones. That's two more water ninja for to boost Chojuro. So that puts you at 36% increased damage every round. So that's a lot of damage. Even when you lose those two clones, because you will eventually lose those two clones, whether they disappear or whether they're defeated, they get a shield. Your entire team gets a shield from Ao based on 30% of this unit's resistance-based attribute. That's really strong. That is really powerful. It is a really deadly lineup. Mei, let me show, because let me, yeah. So he also acupunctures with his mystery. So that acupuncture is really important. It's on a 3-round cooldown. But he also acupunctures with his chase. So causing that chase and getting that chase off can be really important and can be the difference between winning and losing. So, Mei. Since I don't have Mei, I can't exactly show you. So, Vapor Style Acid Explosion. Causes water and fire attribute damage, causes ignition to up to seven opponents' units and low float. Really powerful, super good against big teams, really good in Great Ninja War, really good in Team Instance, really good in Strong Approach. Really good in general. So her water style Flowing Whip attacks the opponent's front row and has a chance of three combo knockdown and acupuncture. So that acupuncture again. We're dealing with another acupuncture. So it's possible to get acupuncture on two to three opponents' units in one round, which is really, really nice. Her charm, she increases damage to male characters by 25%. So that can be important when dealing with certain lineups, like because at in the end of the game, you're gonna fight a lot of Roshi lineups, a lot of Han lineups, a lot of Sage Naruto lineups. You're gonna fight a lot of lineups now with Edo Deidara, with Kakazu, with Kisame. So you're fighting a lot of male characters. So these male characters are gonna take 25% increased damage from Mei. That is a lot of damage. That is a lot of extra damage that you can do. So she also puts up a barrier that buffs water and fire ninjas by 40%. That is a lot. 40% ninjutsu and attack. That's huge. Now, also, each round she damages two individual units of your opponent. So that's two layers of that's two pieces of poison. That's a layer of poison on two different characters. That's important. Her chase, she also immobiles with her chase. Knock down to low flow and immobile. That immobile is going to be the difference between living and dying in some cases. So that is really important. Immobile is great in a chase. Getting someone immobile is amazing because they can't use their standard attack and they can't use their mystery. It also interrupts the mystery. So having that immobile is amazing. So going back to this lineup. Because all of these ninja buff from each other, this team can get really deadly. Now, you have a couple options here. If you're using Mei, you've already unlocked most of this stuff because you're at level 70, give or take. So you have a lot of options with what you can run. I recommend Poison Tie. And I recommend healing tips. And I recommend using regenerative healing jutsu and healing jutsu. Now, I say that because number one, your team is already doing a lot of control, a lot of acupuncture, and an immobile. So you don't really need this chaos unless you find yourself up against a lot of healers that are healing the same person over and over and over again. So your immobiles and your acupunctures aren't doing anything. So this chakra blade might help with chaosing one of the healers. So that could, at that point you would want to put neurotoxin and chakra dissection blade. But I would recommend staying with healing tips and then using whichever chase works best. Because you don't have to hit a certain amount of combo and you don't really have to hit these because you'll unlock your summons and you'll be able to make up for whatever you're not able to combo off of. So that is a really solid team. So that would be Chojuro first action, Ao second action, Mei third action, and then Water Main. Really, really solid lineup. Another lineup that I like to do. So this is more of the higher end people who are paying a little bit of money. Your Hidan Death Possession Blood. He does a crap ton of damage, just flat damage. He is really powerful. He tags three units, causes eight combo on each unit. So he does a 24 combo. 24 combo, and those units suffer from tag. His standard attack causes damage to up to six ninjas suffering from tag, including himself. Will give priority to this unit, to the units with the highest life and attack attribute. So he attacks the strongest ninjas first. That is important. He deals a crap ton of damage to the strongest ninjas on the team. That is a very, very deadly ninja. The lower his life, the higher his attack is. Another important trait because he deals damage to himself. So if he's sitting there at 1 HP and he stabs himself and he hits four people, he's almost going to one-shot them. It is a very, very dangerous team. He's a very dangerous ninja. Once he is defeated, he will resurrect in two rounds. Another very, very important factor. Now, I run Killer B in this lineup because number one, he can shield Roshi and keep him alive for an extra turn, maybe, hopefully. The second reason is because he is immune to all debuffs. That's great. It's amazing. Third reason is for his prompt. Yo will give an extra standard attack to a selected unit. and their mystery is immune to interruption for 2 rounds. With Hedonn in the lineup, being able to stab himself twice, hitting 3 to 4 people each time, that is a lot of damage going out. That is a whole lot of damage, and that amount of damage can really, really destroy someone's lineup. Now, I use my water main as a healer, and I use the water style water trumpet. Oh, why am I messed up on my talents? Okay, so there we go. So I run regenerative healing jutsu, water style water trumpet, because it triggers with a 10 combo, so it triggers on Hedonn. Hedonn causes a 24 combo with his mystery. Then I cause a 5 combo on 2 different people, so that's a 10 combo. That puts me at 34. 34 combo, and then Chameleon can chase, and he does a little bit of damage. That 34 combo right there triggers Roshi's combo, which deals damage to 4 opponent units and causes ignition on them. That is huge. That is major. It is a lot of damage. It is very dangerous. So, those are some other team ideas. For Ninetales, I recommend using Haku, because and not the Edo Tensei version, even though the Edo Tensei version is a little bit better. I can prompt this mystery, or I can cast this mystery twice during a Ninetales event. So on the first round, I use Haku, and on the fourth round, the third end of the third round, I'll have enough chakra to use her mystery again, which causes damage. And then on the fourth round, the cooldown is reset, and I'm able to put up another barrier, and Suigetsu and Water Main deal a lot more damage. So for this, I use Skewering, Water Style Flowing Whip, Water Style Trumpet, Water Style Enhancement, and Water Clone Jutsu. The Water Clone is going to take some of the damage from the Ninetales when he swipes, so your team is not taking damage, which is nice. I use Guy for the attack boost, and the Leech. The Leech is nice when he attack when the Ninetales attacks. So I'm buffing these three ninja up here. Those are my main damage. And then he's buffing everyone, which is really nice. Plus the barrier is buffing everyone. And all these guys are under attack, and my water main is in ninjutsu because these three are all attack based. Taijutsu, a ninjutsu that doesn't do any damage, and then taijutsu and ninjutsu, taijutsu. Suigetsu, taijutsu, taijutsu, and then 2 ninjutsu abilities. That's important. Deals a lot of taijutsu damage. That's where your attack comes from. Haku, even though her barrier says ninjutsu, when she uses her barrier again, she actually deals damage. So on the third round, end of the third round, you're going to deal damage, and it's actually attack damage and ninjutsu damage. So you're doing taijutsu and ninjutsu, so that's coming from your attack. Then her standard is taijutsu attack, which obviously is taijutsu. So that's important. All of them deal a lot more damage when you have them on the attack lineup. So that is my Ninetales team. I use Haku first, then I use Water Main and Suigetsu, then I use Guy, and then at the end of the third round where I used Guy, I use Haku. Really strong team. I usually get first, second, or third, depending on who's in the Ninetales event. So, back here, who else is useful to the water main? Not many people, actually. It's really funny. Roshi is good with just about any lineup, so use Roshi if you get Roshi. Most cancer teams will run Roshi, Hokage Tsunade, and Sailor Sakura because they deal a lot of healing. Tsunade can chaos, so that's important. And Roshi can stack up enough times and deal a lot of damage, so that's also important, because Roshi is going to be your main damage in those cancer lineups. Another lineup that I see a lot is going to be Sailor Sakura, Han, Water Main, and Roshi, You have Roshi and Han in the front, and then you have Watermain and Sailor Sakura in the back. And they're healing up Han and Roshi constantly, keeping them up for as long as possible. So you have your Watermain working as a healer with healing tips, and it's just amazing. So, as I was saying earlier, Hashirama is really good. His barrier buffs Earth and Water Ninja. Oh, no, it doesn't. I'm a liar. Hashirama's barrier increases the attack and ninjutsu for Konoha Ninja. For some reason, I thought it was Water and Earth. Whoops. And before the first action in the round, when using this barrier, when attacking your opponent's team, it will cause damage to two random units and will cause them to suffer from immobile. Really, really, really powerful. So his standard attack, the opponent's front row and has a chance of four combo and low float. Ninja God at the beginning of battle increased the ninjutsu by 30% of all units on your team for 5 rounds. If you get Hashirama, put him into the Ninetales lineup. Non-negotiable, really important, really powerful, ridiculous amounts of damage. So, he also causes interruption with his chase, which is really important for that extra interrupt, extra crowd control ability. Super important. He also gains life each round, which is good, but it's only when you gain chakra. So if you combo him with someone like Kisame, that can be really powerful. Joni Minato, really good. If you get him, put him in your lineup. Fourth Hokage is good, don't get me wrong, but I would prefer having Jonin Minato. But if you get Fourth Hokage Minato, put him in your lineup. He's worth it. He deals a lot of damage. Chikamatsu Chiyo is not super great. Her chases are nice. Because you can trigger them each 3 times. So you can deal a lot of damage with your chases. And if you're having. Sometimes they do an event for chase damage where you have to chase Orochimaru a certain amount of times in order to get certain rewards. So if you get Chikamatsu Chiyo, save her for that event. She's not a super strong ninja, so don't rely on her in battles. Edo Deidara, if you get him, put him in your lineup. Edo Kakuzu, if you get him, put him in your lineup. Sai, even though he's a water ninja, is not super strong. He basically is the water version of Naruto, because he summons 1 to 2 beast imitation drawings to fight for you with his standard attack. And his clones are capable of standard attack. So that's the only difference between him and Naruto, is his clones can attack. With his sealing jutsu, if you really need an immobile, then do it, because it does a lot of damage, but not enough to make him viable in PvP, in my opinion. So, use at your discretion. Conan is really good if you're able to tag your opponents. If otherwise, she's not that great. Again, the pain's all amazing. Yeah, Jigakudo resurrects a unit in your lineup. He heals 2 units, will also cancel 2 debuffs. Recovers 10 chakra points and 10 points of your life every time a unit dies, can be triggered 6 times. Gakido generates a shield to a selected unit. This shield is based on 80% of this unit's resistance base attribute. Really powerful. It also makes the unit immune to debuffs for 1 round. Really, really, really important. Really, really, really strong. Hanzo. If you get Hanzo, you can run him in a water main lineup. He cancels all debuffs done to you. With his, like, right before each action. Cancel one debuff on an individual from your entire team, on each individual from your entire team. So that's really powerful. We talked about Mei. A is really good in any lineup. If you get him, put him in your lineup. Onoki is not gonna benefit the water main. Donzo. Donzo's situational. If you need the knockdown and immobile, use him. If you need to, if you're running like someone like, if you're running Hidan and you find Hidan dying a lot, or if you find your Roshi dying a lot, run Donzo. They can really help. Darui is a good replacement for Mei if you don't have Mei, but he's not a permanent replacement for Mei. So if you get Mei, use Mei instead of Darui. But if you get Darui instead of Mei, run Darui. He's really powerful. His barrier buffs Lightning and Water Ninja, so you have a little bit more flexibility on what you can run in your lineup. We talked about Mifune, or no, we didn't talk about Mifune, but Mifune doesn't matter. Mifune's bad. Actually, Mifune is really good, but he doesn't benefit the water main very much. Chojuro, we talked about Chojuro. Mabui heals one unit with the least life from your team and disperse all debuff on him. Really good, really strong. Really situational in my opinion, because she's mainly used with Great Ninja War Sakura for that chakra, and using Great Ninja War Sakura turn one, that is really what she's used for. However, if you're running into situations where you need shields because you're taking way too much damage in the first round, Mabui is a good option for that. Itachi Susanoo, really expensive, like really expensive. Did I mention he's really expensive? But he is amazing. He's really powerful. Like he's worth, I don't know if he's worth the money to pay for him, but if you get him, put him in your lineup. Han, his mystery is a two-phase mystery. He cancels all shields and buffs from both fields, and then you can use that skill again to basically, well, destroy an opponent's lineup and cause a knockdown to a selected unit. Really powerful. Attacks up to three of the opponent's units in the front row and has a fixed chance of causing knockdown to a targeted unit. Has a high chance of evading a standard attack. Can be triggered once each round. He also has super armor, so he is a low, immune to low float, high float, repulse, and knockdown. Fu, not really that good with a water main. She's mainly good with a blitz team. Shikaku, no, not really. Nagato, really good. If you get him, use him. Like, seriously, if you get him, use him. Gengetsu, we kind of talked about him. Deals a truckload of damage for water main. Samui and Omui are not that great with the water main. Use them with a lightning main if you have them. Kinkaku, Genkaku. I personally think they're both garbage. But if you need these crowd control, they're worth it. Mu, not going to benefit the water main. Third Raikage, really strong. If you get him, put him in your lineup, but don't keep him there. Masked Man, ridiculously powerful. If you get him, put him in your lineup. Don't second guess yourself. Kushina and Raza, not going to benefit the water main very much. And then those two are just kind of stock. Going back up a little bit. Let me see if there's anyone else that would benefit from, or the water main would benefit from. Tenten, Great Ninja War Tenten. Both of them are really strong. Great Ninja War Tenten is ridiculously powerful. Like, she can basically annihilate teams really quickly. It's kind of terrifying. Zabuza is good situationally. I prefer to use the Miss Seven Swordsman Zabuza because if you need an immobile second round, you know, you're good. You've got that immobile. It's 40 chakra though, so if you use it second round, you're not doing much. He also does two standard attacks every round, so that's important too. Really strong. Yagura is another great ninja for water main. If you have Roshi, combo Yagura with Roshi. I personally don't like using Yagura with Roshi much because it's situationally good. Like if you're able to, if you have King of Hell and you have, or you have guys Tortoise, Or you have the new crab that came out. Use Yagura with Roshi. Because you can get the extra chases, you can get the extra combos. So you can get extra healing if you need it. So Yagura is a really good choice. He also has an acupuncture in his chase. So if you get Yagura, use Yagura with Roshi. Don't use Yagura by himself, really, unless you really, really, really need it. But yeah, use Yagura with Roshi. Really good. Really powerful. Too OP. We talked about Sai. Sailor Sakura, if you get Sailor Sakura, use Sailor Sakura. Suigetsu is pretty good situationally. He's more of a pseudo tank that deals a truck ton of damage. He's also really easy to get to 5-star. So if you're able to get Suigetsu to 5-star and he's your strongest ninja, obviously use him. He's not hard to combo with, so you can combo with him pretty easily. And obviously, Great Ninja War Sakura. We had a monthly event where they were giving away Great Ninja War Sakura for free, just for signing in. So everyone got her to 3 stars really quickly. But if you get Great Ninja War Sakura, use her for as long as you can. She'll be really powerful. Late game, she isn't as powerful, but she can also take a lot of pressure off of certain ninjas. So she's really strong situationally. So use her if you can and when you can. Yeah, I think that about covers it. Anyway, oh, Kisame. We didn't talk about Kisame. He absorbs chakra like there's no tomorrow. So if you're running high chakra usage teams, second round you can absorb all of your opponent's chakra. If you're gonna use Kisame, I would recommend using him first action and then having someone like Ao or Naruto, regular Naruto, not Sage Naruto, in your team, because those clones can save Kisame from an extra damage. He also recovers life every time he absorbs chakra. So every time your team absorbs chakra, so even every mo every the start of every round, he's gonna gain chakra. So he's gonna gain life from that. So if you use him first action so he can gain the extra chakra really quickly. He's really powerful with the water main. He's really powerful in a lot of teams actually, but not many people use him. If you get Shark Mode Kisame, you're gonna use him obviously because he's probably the best ninja in the game right now. He's really deadly. He launches a barrier for 1 round and summons 3 sharks. And the barrier interrupts all mystery skills for that round. So if you get this Kisame, put him first action, use him as a tank, and just annihilate your opponent. He's really powerful. So use him. And Edohaku, she's good if you don't have Mei or Darui, but I wouldn't use her if you had any other choice. All right, well, that is all, folks. That's all. Yeah. Okay. So sorry the video took so long. If you found this video helpful or you enjoyed listening to me talk for almost an hour, I think, like and subscribe down below. I'll be posting some more videos. Post in the comment section below what main character you'd like to see next. I'm going to try and keep these videos updated as much as possible. I'm going to try and keep them as thorough as possible so that you guys can get the maximum experience from watching these videos and learning how to create your teams. So, like, subscribe. Anyway, thanks, guys. Later.